Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 5.3 in the sequencing model, and we are going to discuss about the processing two jobs in N machines and processing N jobs in M machines. In the earlier two lectures on the sequencing model, we discussed the processing N jobs in two machines and three machines. Now we take processing two jobs in N machines and processing N jobs in M machines. We discussed the theory part of the model, sequencing model and the solution, and we solve problems in the two models in the sequencing problem. The learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the sequencing model. Processing two jobs in N machines. So we take the assumption there are M machines denoted by A, B, C up to K. There are different machines, more machines are available, but there are only two jobs. They are designated as job 1 and job 2. The technological order of each job. So what is the sequence, each job? So job 1, what are all the machines involved for job 1, and what is the time required for job 1 in a particular machine, and what sequence it is to be taken to different machines, that is again given. That is what technological order. Technological ordering of each job is given in advance. And the processing time for each job, job 1 and job 2 in different machines, A1, A2, A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2 up to K2, they are also known. So the time for each job in each machine is known, and what is the order in which each job is to be processed in different machines, that is also given in the problem. And we discuss the procedure with the help of a numerical example. So using the graphical method to minimize the time needed to process the following jobs on machine A, B, C, D, find the total elapsed time to complete both the jobs. There are two jobs, J1 and J2, or job 1 and job 2, and there are four machines involved, A, B, C, D. Now for job 1, the machine, the sequence of operation, the job for job 1 first goes to the job machine A, it is processed for 2 hours, then it goes to the machine B, it is processed in the 3 hours, machine C 5 hours, and machine D 2 hours, and it is delivered. Whereas job 2, it is processed in the following sequence. Job D machine, first it goes to the machine D for 6 hours, then machine C for 2 hours, then machine A for 3 hours, then finally it goes to the machine B for 1 hour and it is being delivered. So for job 1, job 2, the sequence is given. For job 1, the sequence is ABCD. For job 2, the sequence is DCAB. And the time is also given here. So 2352 and 6231. Now we have to find out the total elapsed time for completing the two jobs in four machines. So the procedure, the solution procedure: draw two axes perpendicular to each other representing processing job 1 in horizontal axis, processing job 2 in the vertical axis. So you have to draw the, better you take the graph sheet. So using the graph sheet we can easily complete the solution. So job 1 in the x-axis or the horizontal axis, job 2 in the vertical axis. Layout the processing time on the corresponding axis in the given technological order. So we prepare the layout. So for example, job 1 in the x-axis, the order is ABCD and the time is 2352. And similarly for vertical axis, the job is job 2, the timing order is DCAB and the timing 6231. Then machine A require 2 hours to process job B and 3 hours to process job 2. So look at here, machine A. So here A require 2 hours for job 2, 1, and for 3 hours for job 2. Right? So make a rectangle for machine A. So for machine A, you have to make a rectangle. Similarly, for other machines, you have to make the rectangle. So we take the entire solution in the next slide. So here is the answer. So first, what you have to do? We have to draw the x-axis for job 1, y-axis for job 2, and for job 1 the order is A, B, CD. For job 2, the order is DCAP. And the timing, for both the job, the timing is sum of the timing. So, 12. Here again, it is 12. So, sum of the timing is 12. So, 12 hour. Job 1, 12 hours in the x-axis. Job 2, 12 hours in the y-axis. So, if you have a graph sheet, so we can take 1 centimeter equal to 1 hour and it is comfortable for us. Now, the job 1, machine A require 2 hours, machine B require 1, 2, 3 hours, machine C require 2, 4, 5 hours and machine D require 2 hours. And similarly for job 2, machine D require 6 hours, machine C require 2 hours, machine A require 3 hours and machine B require 1 hour. Now, for machine A, so here we have the machine A 2 hours, here we have the machine A for 3 hours, so you make a rectangle for machine A. So, this is, here I have shown some color, you can use the hatching, so you can hatch in your graph sheet for machine A. Then for machine B, so for job A, it is 3 hours, 1, 2, 3 hours, for job 2, it is 1 hour. So, this is the machine B, the timing, utilization or use of the time machine B. And similarly, job C. So, job C, x-axis, job 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hours. For job 2, it is 2 hours. So, we prepare the rectangle for machine C. Then, for machine D, 2 hours for job 1. And 6 hours for job 2, we prepare the rectangle for machine D. So, A, this is this rectangle for machine A, this rectangle for machine B and this rectangle for machine C and here it is machine D, utilization of machine D. Now, we have to draw the line, we have to start from the origin. So, we have to start from here, reach in the opposite corner and we have to draw only, you have to reach there. Only by inclined line, vertical line, horizontal line and again inclined line without crossing any of the rectangle. So, the condition is you can reach from the origin to the opposite corner by connecting inclined line, horizontal line, vertical line without crossing any of the machine, any of the rectangle, that is the condition. So, I have drawn here from 0 up to this point inclined line, so 5 hours. Then I draw a vertical line for 3 hours and horizontal line for 3 hours. Again, vertical inclined line for 4 hours. So, what is the meaning for inclined line, vertical line, horizontal line? The meaning for inclined line is both jobs are under process. Both jobs are under process. Vertical line, job 1 is idle. Job 1 is idle, job 2 is under process. Horizontal line, job 2 is idle. And job 1 is under process. So, that is the meaning. So, I repeat the procedure. You prepare the, you take a graph sheet, mark the timing, total timing in the x-axis and y-axis, x-axis for job 1, y-axis for job 2. You write the technological order A, B, C, D and you mark the timing for technological order. Similarly, in the job 2, you write the technological order and prepare the rectangle. For 4 machines, you prepare the rectangle. And connect, you start from the origin, move towards the opposite corner by 3 different types of lines. Inclined line, vertical line, horizontal line without crossing any of the rectangle. So, the rectangle, inclined line indicates processing the 2 jobs. Vertical line indicates job 2 is under process, job 1 is idle. Horizontal line indicates job 2 is idle and job 1 is under process. And so, that is what? See, starting from the origin, reach the finish point by combination of horizontal line, vertical line in 45 degree inclined line without crossing any of the rectangles. Horizontal line represents processing job 1 and idle for job 2. Vertical line represents processing job 2 and idle of job 1. Inclined line represents processing both the jobs. Now, we calculate the total elapsed time. So, total elapsed time considering job 1, 12 plus 3, 15 hours. Job 2, again 12 plus 3, 15 hours. What is 12? Processing time is 12. For both machine, the idle time is 3 hours. So, total time required for completing the 2 jobs is 15 hours. We take another example. Example number 7. There are 2 jobs to be processed into 4 machines, A, B, C, D. The prescribed technological order are job 1, A, B, C, D, job 2, DBAC. Processing time in hours are given in the following table. So, for machine ABCD, job 1 require 2 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours and 1 hour. And job 2 require 3 hour, 4 hour, 3 hour and 6 hours. So, for job 1, the total number of hours equal to 12. For job 2, the total number of hours equal to 16. So, job 1 require 12 hour, job 2 require 16 hours. Now, we solve the problem. Draw the two axes perpendicular to each other, representing this job 1 in the horizontal axis, job 2 in the vertical axis. Lay out the processing time in the corresponding axis in the given technological order. So, we draw the line, horizontal line for job 1, 12 hours, vertical line for job 2 for 16 hours. So, if it is a graph sheet, it is very comfortable for you. For each centimeter, you can take 1 hour. We can mark 1 centimeter equal to 1 hour. For job 1, the order is ABCD. For job 2, the order is DBAC. For job 1, in machine A require 2 hour, machine B require 1, 2, 3, 4 hour, machine C require 2 plus 3, 5 hours and machine D require 1 hour. And similarly here, job 2 require, in for machine D require 6 hours, for machine B it require 4 hour, machine A require 3 hour and machine C require 3 hour. So, that is what the order given. So, A require 3 hours, C require 3 hours. Right. Now, we take for, look at for machine A, machine job 1, machine A require 2 hours here and for job 2, machine A require 3 hours here. So, for these two, 2 hour, 3 hour, you make a rectangle and this is the machine A. Similarly, for machine B, job 1 require 4 hours, horizontally 4 hours and job 2 require again 7 to 10, 1, 2, 3, 4 hours. So, 4 plus 4, you make the square. So, 4 by 4. Then for job 1, C, machine C require 5 hours. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hours. And machine C, job 2 require 3 hours. So, you make the rectangle for machine C. And the machine D, job 1 require only 1 hour and job 2 require 6 hours. You make the rectangle. So, job 1, x axis, job 2, y axis, you write the technological order. You write the technological order, prepare the rectangle. Now, you connect, start from origin and reach the opposite corner by means of incline line, 45 degree incline line, horizontal line and vertical line. Now, I start with the incline line, 45 degree incline line, reaching. So, 12 plus 12 here, 12. So, it reaches here. Then, I have only vertical line. So, vertical line that indicates job 1 is idle. So, job 2 is under process. So, the total time with respect to job 1, so 12 hours, right, plus idle 4 hours, so 16 hours. For job 2, it is completely 16 hours. So, starting from origin, so all these, so starting from the origin, O reaches the finish point by combination of horizontal line, incline line and vertical, 45 degree incline line without crossing any of the rectangle. Horizontal line represents processing job 1 and idle for job 2 and vertical line represents processing job 2 and idle of job 1. The incline line represents processing both the jobs. Now, the total time, total elapsed time 16 hours. Considering job 1, 12 plus 4 equal to 16. So, 4 hours idle. For considering job 2, 16 plus, there is no idle time for job 2. So, 16 plus 0 equal to 16 hours. So, the total time is 16 hours. Example number 8 again, we take another problem in the processing of two jobs in N machines. So, use graphical method to find the maximum minimum elapsed time, time sequence of the two jobs in 5 machines when the following informations are given. So, job 1, job 2 is given. Job 1, the sequence is A, B, C, D, E and times are 2, 3, 4, 6, 2 and the job 2, the sequence is C, A, D, E, B, C, A, D, E, B and the timing are 4, 5, 3, 2, 1 hour. So, these are all the details given. Now, draw the horizontal axis for job 1 and the vertical axis for job 2 and the total time, count the total time for job 1, 5, 15, 17 hours and for job 2, 14, 20 hours. So, 5 plus 5, 10, 20 hours. So, 20 hours job for job 2 and 17 hours for job 1. And we mark, so job 1, 17 hours, and job 2, 20 hours. And here we take the technological order. Job 1, A, B, C, D, E. For job 2, C, A, D, E, and B. For job 1, the timing 2 hours, and here 3 hours, and here machine C, 4 hours, and machine D, 6 hours, and machine E, 2 hours. And in the y axis, for job 2, machine C, 4 hours, machine A, 5 hours, machine D, 3 hours, machine E, 2 hours, and machine B, 6 hours. So these are all the timing. Then for look for the machine A, for machine A, so 2 hours for job 1, and here 5 hours for job 2, you make a rectangle for machine A. Machine B, job 1, here 3 hours for job 1, and here 6 hours for job 2, and you make the rectangle. So machine B. And machine C, x axis, 4 hours for job 1, and 4 hours for job 2, you make the square. Machine D, x axis, 6 hours for job 1, and 3 hours for job 2, you make the rectangle. And machine E, 2 hours for job 1, and 2 hours for job 2, you make the rectangle. So, you make the rectangle for the given information. So, E machine, 2 hours, so you may prepare the rectangle. Now, we have to draw the line, incline line. You have to start from the origin, reach the opposite corner by means of incline line, 45 degree incline line, vertical line, and 45 degree incline line. So, this incline line indicates both the jobs are processed, and this incline line indicates both the jobs are processed. This vertical line indicates the job 2 is in process, job 1 is idle. So, job 1 is idle for 3 hours. So, 1, 2, 3 hours. So, job 2 is continuously, it is under process for continuously 20 hours. Now, the procedure, starting from the origin O, reach the finish point by combination of horizontal line, vertical line, and 45 degree incline line without crossing any of the rectangles. Horizontal line represents the processing one job 1 and idle job 2. And vertical line represents processing job 1, vertical line represents processing job 2 and idle for job 1. The incline line represents processing both the jobs. And total answer to the problem, total elapsed time. So, considering job 1, so the processing time is 17 hours, idle time is 3 hours, total 20 hours. Considering job 2, the processing time is 20 hours, there is no idle time for job 2, and total time is 20 hours. So, for completing the 2 jobs in the 5 machines, the total time required is 20 hours. So, we take next to the processing n jobs in n machines. So, earlier we discussed the processing n jobs in 2 machines. Then we solved problem in the processing n jobs in 3 machines. And we solved in the earlier previous discussion, we discussed the problem solving problem. 2 jobs in M machines, and we take up now processing N jobs in M machines. And the assumption, various assumptions, there are N jobs to be processed denoted by 1, 2, 3 up to N. There are M machines involved A, B, C up to K, and each job is processed only in the prescribed order, and passing is not allowed. So, the passing of the job from one machine to another machine is not at all allowed. The processing time for each job in different machines are given below in the table. So, this is the machine. So, we have N machines, we have N jobs and M machines, different machines up to K machines. So, the processing time is given A1, A2 up to AN, B1, B2 up to BN, similarly K1, K2 up to KN. So, this is the table indicates the processing time of different jobs in different machines. And we have to solve, the above problem is converted. Now, we have to convert the problem into processing n jobs into 2 machines. What we solved first, the first type of sequencing problem. Then we have to use the algorithm for solving the problem. Then the processing time for 2 equivalent machines are AI, capital AI. So, machine small AI, small BI are the 2 equivalent machines. the timing is calculated. For small ai, starting from the first machine up to k minus 1 machine, the process time of k minus 1 machine. For the second equivalent machine, starting from the second machine to the last machine. So, a, b I plus c I plus d I up to k I, for small a I equal to capital A I plus b I plus c I up to k minus 1 I. And here again the condition is to be satisfied. Any one of the following conditions should be satisfied to apply the algorithm. Minimum time of A should be greater than or equal to maximum time of B, C or K minus 1. Or minimum time of K should be greater than or equal to maximum time of B, C up to K minus 1. This is the condition to be satisfied to apply the algorithm, to apply the solution procedure. So, we take one example. Example number 9, determine the optimal sequence of the following jobs. So, we have 5 jobs and we have 4 machines. So, A, B, C, D are the machines, J1, J2, J3, J4, J5 are the jobs. So, the processing times are given. For J1, 8, 3, 4, 7, for J2, 9, 2, 5, 5, for J3, 6, 4, 5, 8, for J4, 12, 5, 1, 9, for J5, 7, 1, 2, 3. Now, we have to solve the problem, we have to find out the optimum sequence. Now, the minimum time of machine A is 6 hours, is greater than or equal to minimum time on the machine B. So, the maximum time for machine B is 5 hours and here again the maximum time is 5 hours. So, the maximum time is greater than the minimum time of the first column. So, the condition is satisfied, we can apply the algorithm. Now, the processing time for small a I, small b I, a I capital A I plus b I plus c I, for small b I capital b I plus c I plus b I. So, the 4 machines we have taken converted into 2 machines. Now, the processing time. So, J1, J2, J3 up to J5. Now, we have a I equal to 15, 16, 15, 18, 10. Small b I equal to 14, 12, 17, 15 and 6. Now, the procedure. So, procedure to solve the problem, we have to check the minimum value. Examining the processing time, the minimum time is 6 hours for the job 5, falls in the second column. So, this is the minimum time. Process the job last in the machine A. So, starting the A, we have to actually the processing order is A, B, C, D. Last in the machine A and cross out the job J5. So, when the job J5 is crossed out, so we have remaining job. So, the remaining jobs are 4 jobs, J1, J2, J3, J4. Now, we again examine the table, examine the processing time. The minimum time is 12 hours. Now, the 12 hours, the machine, it is again falling on the second column for the job J2. Now, we have to process the job J2 prior to J5. So, this is the processing of J2. Then, remove the J2. Remove the J2 row, remaining J1, J3 and J4 is available. Now, again, we have J1, J3 and J4, they are available. So, the timings are given here. Now, we examine the table. The timing is 14 hours. So, 14 hours is the minimum time. Now, 14 hours, it is again falling on the second column. We take for the job J1. Now, the job J1 is processed prior to J2. Now, remove the row J1 and the remaining two jobs are J3 and J4. Now, the minimum time is 15 hours. So, the 15 hours for both the job, for J3 it is falling on the first column, for J4 it is falling on the second column. Now, the J3 is processed first and J4 is processed second and this is the sequence J3, J4, J1, J2 and J5. So, this is the sequence of 5 jobs. Now, we calculate the total time. So, J3, J4, J1, J2, J5, this is the processing order and the processing time, the total time is 48 hours for processing all the jobs in 4 different machines. For J3, it enters the machine A at 0 hours, leaves at 6 hours. It immediately enters the machine B, leaves at 10 hours. Then it enters at the machine C at 10 hours, leaves at 15 hours. Then it enters the machine D 15 hours and leaves at 23 hours. J4 is entering here at 6 hours, leaving at 18 hours. Then again enters the next machine B machine, 18 hours, leaves at 23 hours. Again enters the machine C, 23 hours, leaves at 24 hours. Then again, machine D, 24 hours and leaves at 33 hours. Job J1 enters the machine A, 18 hours, leaves at 26 hours. Machine B, 26 hours, leaves at 29 hours. And here it enters at 29 hours, leaves at 33 hours. And here machine D enters at 33 hours, leaves at 40 hours. And J2 enters at 26 hours, leaves at 35 hours, again immediately enters the machine B at 35 hours, leaves at 37 hours, immediately enters the machine C at 37 hours, leaves at 42 hours, again enters immediately next to the machine D, 42 hours and leaves at 45 hours. For job J5, enters on 35th hour machine A, 42nd hour leaves the machine A, then machine B enters at 42 hour, leaves at 43 hour, machine C enters at 43 hour, leaves at 45 hours, and machine D, it enters at 45 hours, leaves at 48 hours. So we calculate the total elapsed time, 48 hours. So total elapsed time is 48 hours. Idle time for machine A. Machine A, the all the 5 jobs are completed the 42nd hour and it is waiting up to 48 hours. So idle time is 6 hours. For machine B, so look at here, initially it is waiting for 6 hours. Then job 1 is completed at 10 hour, but it is waiting for 18 hours. So here 8 hours waiting time, here 3 hours waiting time, here 6 hours waiting time, and here 5 hours waiting time, 37 to 42, 5 hours waiting time, and the 43 jobs are completed and it is waiting up to 48 hours. So again 5 hours waiting time. So 6 plus 8 plus 3 plus 6 plus 5 plus 5 equal to 33 hours. Then for machine C, look at here, initially 10 hours it is waiting, then 15 hours, next it is waiting for 8 hours, 24 hours waiting for 5 hours, 33 hours waiting for 4 hours, 42 hours waiting for 1 hour, and 45 hours waiting for 3 hours. So 10 plus 8 plus 5 plus 4 plus 1 plus 3 equal to 31 hours. Our machine D, initially it is waiting for 15 hours. So first job enters only after 15 hours, and here it is waiting for 1 hour. So here there is no waiting time, here waiting for 2 hours, and here there is no waiting time. So 15 plus 1 plus 3 equal to 18 hours. So this is the total elapsed time, 48 hours, and idle time for machine A, 6 hours, machine B, 33 hours, machine C, 31 hours, and machine D, 18 hours. So this is the answer to the problem. And we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find operation research. There is one book, operation research. You can use the book for additional problem in the sequencing model. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again another video lecture in the subject operation research. Until then, bye bye.